हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर शशि त्यागी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस आर्टिफिशियल वेरिएबल टेक्निक सेकंड फॉर सॉल्विंग एलपीपी। समटाइम्स वी हैव कंस्टेंट्स हैव द साइन ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू और इक्वल टू विद ऑल बी आई इज पॉजिटिव। फॉर ग्रेटर देन कंस्टेंट्स वी नीड surplus variable and equal to we need an artificial variables. For making basic matrix B equal to IM, we need sometimes artificial variables. For solving these type of problems where we have artificial variables, we have two methods. First is two-phase method and second is Bingham method. Two-phase method we already discussed in previous lecture. Today we will discuss Bingham method or Karner's M method. Bingham method or Karner's M method. In this method, a very large negative price, say minus m, is assigned to each artificial variable in the objective function z. So this, due to this negative price in the objective function, cannot be improved in presence of artificial variable. Z cannot be improved. So first we remove the artificial variables from the basic using simplex method, as usual simplex method. When we remove this artificial variable, we forget about it, and final simplex table makes simplex table without artificial variable and go to simplex as usual simplex method for getting an optimal solution. For clear understanding, consider this example. Here maximum z equal to minus 2x1 minus x2 and subject to constraint which have equal to first constraint equal to sign and in second constraint greater than sign and third constraint less than equal to sign. For greater than equal to sign, we need a surplus variable x3, and less than equal to constraint, we need a slack variable x4. For making equality or canonical form, we need artificial variable in first and second constraints xa1 and xa2. So finally our problem is convert in this form: maximum z equal to subject maximum z equal to minus 2x1 minus x2 plus 0x3 plus 0x4 and minus mxa1 minus mxa2, where m is a very large number, positive number, and x3 is surplus variable, x4 is slack variable, and xa1 and xa2 are artificial variable. Now make a simplex table of this type. In the simplex table, in the basic, we have artificial variable a1 a2 and y4. Calculate as usual simplex table, where we calculate z equal to cbxb and delta j is zj minus cj, and now apply the test for optimal solution. Choose maximum delta j, which is equal to minus 2 plus 7m, and here is minus m, here is 1 plus 4m. So maximum delta j is this related to variable y1. This means y1 enter in basic and now find minimum ratio. Minimum ratio is 3 by 3 is 1. This is minimum ratio. Some students have difficulty to calculate minimum ratio. Minimum ratio is xb over yk, where yk greater than equal to 0. Yk greater than equal to 0. So we take yk value is only greater than equal to 0, not 0, and avoid 0 and negative value of yk. Okay. Now find the key element or pivotal element is 3. This is a11, so we make a11 is 1 and rest of the elements is 0 using row operation. Finally we get this matrix, so we can see easily from the basic artificial variable a1 removed from the basic. Now calculate again delta j and choose maximum delta j. This means y2 enter in the basic and calculate minimum ratio. Minimum ratio is this. This means the vector, artificial vector a2, yeah, artificial variable a2 remove from the basic. So we get this table y1, y2, y4 in the basic, no artificial variable here. And when we remove artificial variable a1, we did not calculate this column. And if we remove a1 and a2 also artificial variable, so we do not calculate these columns regarding a1 and a2. We leave this. So we forget artificial variables because in the basic we have only original variable y1, y2 and a slack variable y4. Now this is the table without artificial variables. And now apply usual simplex method. Calculate z is this and delta j for all variables and check whether delta j is less than equal to 0. Here all delta j are less than equal to 0. This is the condition of optimality. Therefore we get an optimal solution. This maximum z is minus 12 by 5, x1 is 3 by 5, x2 is 6 by 5. So that's all about the simplex method for artificial variables. So student, I hope you understand well this Bigham method. If you have any problem, write in my comment box. And students, you need a written notes, then write your email address or WhatsApp number for written notes. And if you like this video, press the like button and subscribe my channel also. Thank you for watching.